art my strength. Truly thou art my redeemer. Lord, we just thank you for this day. Thank you for your wisdom, for your sovereign power. Thank you for your strength. We continue to pray your anointing power upon all those who are sick. We ask that you continue to bless Deacon Evan Sam. We ask, Lord, that you would continue to bless this church family. Keep us surrounded, Lord, with your protective care. Overshadow us with your divine mercy. Help thy word to go forward, knowing that it will not return void. Strengthen us, Lord. Keep us forever in thy care. In the name of Jesus, the mighty, marvelous, matchless, magnificent, merciful name of Jesus, that we do pray. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Thank the devil tried to warn his way up in here, tried to destroy the spirit of joy and place instead a spirit of heaven. But I'm here to rejoice because God is still God. God is still good. I rejoice because it could have been the other way. But I thank him for what he has done, how he has blessed in the midst. And I give him the praise and the glory. Hallelujah. Sometimes we just take God too lightly. Hallelujah. We just don't know what God really can do. We're more stock in the doctor than we do in God. Hallelujah. I acknowledge that God gives the doctor power and thing, wisdom to do things, but all power is in God's hands. The doctor seemed to fail and frail. God's word will step in. Will deliver. Briefly, Revelation 21, chapter 21, verse 16, says, in the city lie four square, the length is as large as the breadth. Measure the city with the reed, 12,000 furlongs. The length and the breadth and the height of it are equal. That's Revelation 21 and 16. For a few minutes, we just want to talk about. Check it out on all sides. Check it out on all sides. Amen. Revelation is the book of consummation. In it, the divine program of redemption is brought to fruition. The holy name of God is vindicated. In other words, before all creation, it is vindicated. Title means unveiling. Disclosure. It unveils the character and the programming of God. Check it out on all sides. All sides means that it is complete. Focus. A life that is complete on all sides. When John was on the Isle of Patmos, was allowed to view the holy city with 12 foundations. He spoke of the 12 gates, spoke of the jasper stone. The city is light, clear as crystal. Right. But he said that the guy had a measuring reed. And he measured the city. The length, the breadth, the height was equal. All right. In other words, it was all the same on every side. Well, all right. We need to check out our lives. See that our lives are equal on every side. We need to check out our length, our breadth, and our height to make sure that our spiritual lives are aligned on every side. Look at our length. Length means that we reach in. This is our inward concern for ourselves. Our own concern for our own welfare. We must have a grip on who we are. Right. Folks get messed up, tangled up, tied up because they don't know who they are. Huh? Conscious, we got to be conscious of who we are, but not conceited about who we are or what we have. We got to realize that everything we have comes from God. And in a split moment of a second, it can be taken away. It can be removed. just a signature, signing on the dotted line. It can be taken away. It can be removed. We must work to strengthen the inner man, understanding that what makes us something is that God took dust, made a man, breathed into his nostrils, and man, that pile of dust became a living soul. It is no harm to seek the best for yourself, but do not let it control you until you become holy or get beside yourself and think of yourself more highly than you ought to. Keep in perspective who you are by acknowledging whose you are. We are the created creation of a creative God. Hallelujah. One who is benevolent, omnipotent, omnipresent, and omniscient. For without God, we can do nothing. Saints of old had it right. Father, I stretch my hand to thee. No other help I know. If thou withdraw thyself from me, oh, whether shall I go? Let me tell you something. We serve a God that if it was not for him, we could not even take our next breath. Oh, for you said we couldn't put one foot in front of the other. Could not have the right mind. So we are nothing without him. We have to not only look at our length, but we got to look at our breath. That's how wide we are. Our width. This is our outreach to and concern for other folks. Not only ought we be concerned about ourselves and how we are doing, but we ought to be concerned about other folks. We got to balance our lives. We got to have a spiritual concern for others. We are commanded. We're not just advised, but we are commanded to help those who are less fortunate than we are. Amen. He said, the poor you'll always have with you. He said, you can see your brother in need and the bowels of compassion not be open toward that brother from you, that we are worse than an infidel. God provides an opportunity to extend our spiritual will by helping other folks. You know what God says? He says that he that giveth to the poor, lendeth to God. Ain't that something? If anybody want to know how you can lend to God, give to the poor. Awesome. Anyone that sees his brother in need says he's worse than an infidel. We are not to be busy bodies in other men's affairs, but we are to be bodies busily sharing and caring for other folks. Oh, yeah. We ain't supposed to be all up in your business. Trying to find out whose car that is parked in your driveway. Trying to find out how you got that new suit. You ain't really got no good job. That ain't what we're supposed to be about. We're supposed to be busy sharing and caring for our neighbors. I grew up in an era where my mama planted a garden, anybody in the neighborhood could get something. And really, if he wasn't able to come get it, she'd make me put it, plant it, pick it, and all that stuff, and then deliver it to you. Helping somebody. Helping somebody. We didn't have home help, but we had good neighbors who would come in and sit with you all night long. Take care. Wash your clothes. Fix food for you. ourselves now that we don't hardly care about the folks in the house with us. Let alone the folks outside. We not saying we don't care about the folks in the house. We let our children do anything, anyway, anyhow, anytime. And never say a word. A lady was bragging a few weeks ago, her daughter just cussed the folks out of the church. And she said to one of her neighbors, and girl, I didn't say a word. Hope pillow for you. Yeah. Hope pillow for you. Your daughter cussing at church. Round the church. And you didn't say a word. It could have been wrong there. When I come out of that coma, I'd have been eligible for disability and retirement. Yes, you would have. Hallelujah. I had brain damage and couldn't remember them words. Put that towel over your head to cover your roller. And not kept whatever. You go running out there acting a fool with the teacher. You strip the teacher's power. And you empower the child to act any kind of way. Then you turn around and say, and to the grandparents. When they send you a send little Johnny to your house, what mom and dad and I said ain't about nothing at grandma's house. They say go to bed at 8, you let them stay up to 12. He said you're doing the same thing to your child that your children did to the teacher. You're stripping them of their power. And I had to confess, I didn't drink coffee at home, but I drank coffee at grandma's house. Grandma said, that's all right, it won't hurt you. Roman said, I can't do it. Mama said, it's all right, it's all right, it won't hurt you. Then what she won't know won't hurt her. So you got to have a foundation. No other foundation is there other than that which is laid in Jesus. When your foundation is laid in the Lord, you are then ready to have height to your life. Strong prayer life adds to our spiritual height. Faith adds to our spiritual height. Worship and prayer adds to our spiritual height. Steadiness adds to our height. Bible study adds to our height. Sunday school adds to our height. Bible class adds to our height. Love, peace, joy, long suffering, temperance adds to our height. Amen. It'll get us to the point where we become salt. Salt that has not lost its savor. Add to your height. Be like the tree, standing by the rivers of water. Huh? Amen. Said, leave also shall not wither. Whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Young God will not so. Hallelujah. Need to check it out on all sides. Jesus has provided a pattern to place us in the right perspective for salvation. 100% man, 100% divine. Came as man, lived as man, born like an other baby, laid in a manger wrapped in swaddling clothes, lived as man, got hungry like other folks, thirsty like man, tired like man. But he healed as divine. Put the mud on your eyes, man can't back see. Healed as divine. Hallelujah. Open blinded eyes. Loose stammering tongue. Hallelujah. I'm stuck deaf ears. Healed as divine. Matter of fact, the soldiers came and said, no man speaking like this man. I've never seen it done like this before. Came in man, lived in man, healed everybody. Two little fish, $5 load. Fish out of fish. Bread out of bread. Hallelujah. Oh yeah, found him. The Galilean hillside. Y'all more crazy. Biting on himself. Throwing himself in the fire. Nobody could control it. Binding down, they broke out of the bound. Stripped of his clothes. Hallelujah. But when he got to Jesus, Jesus cast out the demons. And when the folks came by, he was clothed and set at the feet of Jesus. That's divine. Got ready to leave. The man said, I want to go with you. I want to be your testimony. Hallelujah. When you have 10 revivals, I want to be the one that step out of the all, go home.
Go home.
Go home.
Go
you left crazy. Go back with a sound mind. Yeah. You left ugly, naked. Go back well dressed. Oh, yeah, you left in bad shape. Folks were whispering about it. Folks were talking about you and your parents and your grandparents. Go back.
Come on. Come on.
Tell them what God has done for you. Tell them how God has saved you. God has made you whole. Go back. He came in man. Living man. He healed as divine. Thank God he was arrested like any other man. He was tried and caught like any other man. And he came to a conclusion that he was guilty, worthy to be killed. Oh, yeah, yeah. He led him to call God. God was healed. Oh, yeah. Like man, he stumbled, he fell. They pulled out. I tried out enough stuff to know ain't nobody like Jesus. first got the base, you sang a song, come on, can't nobody do me like Jesus. And that's a true song. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. He's my friend. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Hallelujah. Those are the treasure. The invitation is extended. Hallelujah. You have not accepted Christ as your Savior.